Oh, poor Red Rock Roxie, an artifact of a forgotten age in MyVegas.
Is the Ace of Vegas, the Ace of Vegas.
You know, I gotta admit, the tunes on this one aren't too bad. Welcome back to Ace of Vegas, Spinners and Sharks. Ace here, and today what we're gonna go ahead and do, we are actually gonna go ahead and play us some Red Rock Roxie now. So, not sure if you guys remember, but for a while, you could actually get some Green Valley Ranch and Red Rock and other station casino rewards in MyVegas slots. Now, unfortunately, that partnership is dissolved, so we don't get those anymore. But there's still a couple artifact games, and Red Rock Roxie is actually proof of it. So if you're looking for a more relaxing spa experience without all the casino noise and all that, then Red Rock is actually probably the hotel and resort that you want to go check out. So, highly recommending that one, but we're going to go ahead and see if the game's any good. So, let me go ahead and set our bet over here. I'm feeling pretty wild today. Let's go ahead and bet $2.4 million every time. So, that means we'll be putting 240 million chips through the machine in total, just to see how we do. So, let's go ahead and put those 100 spins on the clock. On your mark, get set, ready, and go. Alright guys, so first things first, I definitely want to thank you guys for 2,000 subscribers. You have no idea how huge that is to me. Less than a year ago, I had a sum total of 202 subscribers, and today it's straight up 10 times that. That is amazing growth in less than a year, and most of that's actually been in the last 3 months, so this has been quite the summer of Ace of Vegas here. I'm glad that we made the changes that we did, and I'm really happy to have you guys all aboard and have you all part of this dream of mine too. So this has been like really cool. I mean, I really started doing this just really for the fun of it, but it's just been such an amazing experience. We built such an amazing community here, and it's really hard to, I don't think I'll stop ever. I'll stop when I retire, so we're gonna be Ace of Vegas-ing for the next like 40 years right here, guys. It's gonna be hardcore. But no, seriously, thank you all so much for that. Really appreciate it, and really appreciate you guys sitting down, taking the time to help me work on my videos, help me improve my videos, and telling me what you guys want. Also, thanks to you all for sticking it out during the podcast here. I know we were having some troubles. Shout out to my boy, Master Swag King. MSK really kind of stuck it out there. We had some technical glitches. Had to make some settings changes there, too. And I ended up buying a new Nighthawk router. So for you guys that are watching the ads, yes, you paid for a new Nighthawk for me. So we're going to have a much better equipment going forward here. And I think I've got a little left over for a new pop filter, which I desperately need because this old one's kind of ratty. And then a windsock, too, so that I can record outside more frequently because I really do love recording outside. But I'll tell you, the wind is killer on the audio. It just really, really hurts. I really wish I had it for this last Minnesota trip. I just took there, so that was a rough time, but otherwise, you know, when I was indoors, it wasn't so bad. So definitely getting a windsock so we can get outside more, maybe do some strip walks and all that. I'm very much looking forward to that. All right, but yeah, if you guys missed the oh, look at that, 192 million, what a hit there, that's incredible. But yeah, if you guys missed the last podcast, basically what we talked about is we discussed the Luxor Esports Arena. So if you guys aren't familiar with that, it's basically like Major League Gaming on steroids. It's where you can actually play as a casual player, or you can play in professional level tournaments there, just at the Luxor Hotel and Casino. And I'm not just talking about blackjack or slot tournaments or things like that. We're talking about one of my personal favorite games, Super Smash Brothers. Currently, Ultimate is a tournament level video game. If you guys don't know, video games actually are now a major league sport. You can make millions upon millions of dollars doing that like any other professional athlete now, but only if you're the best of the best. Again, just like any other professional athlete. So they have these large-scale tournaments, large-scale competitions and all that, and now Vegas is hosting them in the Luxor Gaming Arena. And I'm thinking this is going to be a bit of a trend going forward, especially considering that the demographic is shifting. We're getting a lot of more millennials that are of age now. I think all millennials are of age now, officially. And, you know, Gen Z is coming up. I think we're going to have the first 21-year-old Gen Zers in the next year or two. So with gaming being such a big thing, that's definitely going to be something that Vegas focuses on in the future, not just casino gaming and making those odds a little more interesting, but definitely bringing bringing skill games to the forefront too. So I think this is going to be a big shift in entertainment in the future. Also, while we're talking about entertainment too, we were also discussing Phil Ruffin. So if you guys aren't familiar with Phil Ruffin, he's the owner of the Treasure Island Hotel and Casino, real estate mogul, friend to Donald Trump and to Steve Wynn, all the other guys on the Vegas Strip. You know what they're about. They're about making that money, dollar bill, and he is trying to make that money too. And he actually got together with his old bestie, Jim Murin, and decided to go ahead and buy the Circus Circus off of Jim and MGM. So, or at least that's the rumor right now. I'm not sure if it's been fully confirmed at this point. I'll have to do a confirmation video on that a little later, just to make sure the research still pans out. But yeah, it looks like Circus Circus will no longer be an MGM M Life property, which, let's be honest, it barely was in the first place. They don't even have an M Life desk over there. I don't think you get M Life points there. You can't use your M Life card. It's ridiculous. They're owned by MGM, but they aren't affiliated with M Life, which I find to be absolutely stupid, but that's on them. That's how they made their money. I assume it was a lease back or something like that. Some gyms made their money off him, and now they're kind of passing the property off, I'm assuming, to cushion the blow for any potential recessions or real estate crashes or anything like that, or even just kind of, you know, down years, because I'm sure they've had some really good up years in the last decade here, not including the 2008 crash, because they had a really rough time from 2008 to about 2011, which is about when MyVegas started. So there's been that. And I'm hoping that just means that it's going to free up some more capital for them, and they can do something with Excalibur and Luxor to kind of clean those up, make those higher tier casinos there. And when we have more competition, we're going to have a better time as consumers. At least that's what I'm thinking. Who knows? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. If Phil Ruffin is going to be a good captain of the ship, or do you think he steered Treasure Island the wrong direction? Do you miss the pirate show? Do you think he screwed up getting rid of that and just screwed up in general running the hotel? And I think that's it, guys. That was the last of the auto spins, and we won on a biggin. All right, guys. So it looks like we have an ending balance of $1,579,398,419 chips. So I'm going to go ahead and take a quick break over here. We're going to do some maths, and we'll count up the booty. Okay, my spinners and sharks, so after doing the math over here, it looks like Red Rock Roxie is going to earn the coveted Ace of Vegas seal of approval. She's going to get a favorite over here because she made us 137.37% payback percentage, which is actually pretty unprecedented, but we made over 100% back, and we got the loyalty points to prove it, so good times there. Speaking of which, are you guys ready to help me spend some loyalty points? So Sunday, we're going to go ahead and do, we're going to do a live stream, so we might do a little bit of game play first. I'm going to go ahead and see about hyping it up on my Konami, just on their fan page over there. We're going to get a lot of people in there, and then you guys are going to help me pick my latest rewards here, so it's going to be a really good time. We're going to go ahead and get on some my Konami, and we're going to pick Ace of Vegas's rewards for my November 18th trip, so it's about 6 weeks out, about time to start picking up some rewards. I cheated a little bit. I picked up a certain reward that's really hard to get, and I'll explain that to you guys later, but it's a really hard one to get, so I thought it would be worth it to pick it up early. So, until next time, my spinners and sharks, Ace of Vegas is signing out, wishing you all strong hands and happy spinning, you guys. Thank you.